You can see the screen. Yes, students, please reply.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Thank you. So today is very, very important, class students. Please see that we are going to find the identities connected with gradient, divergence, and curl. So here, first thing you should know that IJK, which is I direction, J direction, and K direction, here you have to remember, or you can write the note. You have to remember that. You can draw this if you want. I identity is there, which is connected to J, and J is connected to K. It is how? One by one, I, J, and K, they are in circle. With this, we have the node. Okay. So we'll take first one. That is, can anybody tell me what is I cross I? What is the identity? What is this equal to? Any idea, Pooja?
No, sir.
Okay. What about yes?
No, sir.
Okay, it is always zero. Please remember this. Okay, now you at least remember I cross I is zero. J cross J, J is zero, and K cross K is always zero. So this you have to note. Then we continue this. So suppose I cross J is there. Can you tell me what will be this value? I cross J.
Yes.
It is K. So see here, I, after I, if you get J, you will get next K value. Similarly, why this line is getting between, coming between K. So you have to remember this. Then J cross K. Can you tell me what will be J cross K?
I.
It is I. Very good. Similarly, we have K cross I. So this is J. So these are important identities you have to remember. Similarly, we have, suppose if I reverse this, J cross I. Now you tell me what you will get.
So K only.
Yes, K, but in opposite direction. Please remember this, okay? J cross I is how we get K, but in opposite direction. Similarly, K cross J. It is minus I, which is in opposite direction. Similarly, we have I cross K, you will get minus J, which is in opposite direction. This points you have to remember before solving the examples. If you want, you can write it down. Okay, so immediately we'll start with the identities. So in this topic, calculus of vector calculus, this is the last part, friends. If you finish the identities, finish the our portion or syllabus. Okay, so these things you have to remember. Now we'll start with the first identity. So please take down first identity, that is gradient of, one question is fixed for the internal as well as final exam students. Please remember this. So first one, they may ask you like this, prove that. Okay, so you want, you can write this as prove that. See, very simple. LHS is there, you have to find RHS. That's it. So gradient of psi into phi is equal to psi into ग्रेडियंट ऑफ 5 + 5 इनटू ग्रेडियंट ऑफ साई. दिस यू हैव टू प्रूव. सो क्विकली राइट डाउन एंड सिंप्लीफाई दिस. ओके, so what you have to take now? Yes, please take first LHS. Easily you can find RHS, that's it. In between you have to manage. So how you have to manage, I will tell you today. So please take the solution. Now take LHS. So what is LHS we have, student? This is gradient of psi into phi we have. So gradient, we just write this as del of del dot psi into phi. So continue writing, simplify. What is del? Can yes tell me what is del is equal to beta? Yes, Pooja, anyone? What is del is equal to? Yes, try at least.
सर
इन लास्ट क्लास में लिया गिवन, इट इज आई इनटू डो अपॉन डो एक्स प्लस जे इनटू डो अपॉन डो वाई प्लस के इनटू डो अपॉन डो जेड. प्लीज रिमेम्बर दिस, दिस इज अ फॉर्मूला, यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर दिस. यस, ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम. सो विल जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस वैल्यू. So this is I into dou upon dou x plus j into dou upon dou y plus k into dou upon dou z. In the bracket, we get the psi into phi. Okay, so this is the two functions. One by one, you have to simplify. You can take this as u into v. So just simplify this once. So I will take I just multiply this. And with this and with this. Okay, so we'll take here dou upon dou x phi psi into phi plus j into dou upon dou y psi into phi plus k into dou upon dou z psi into phi. Yes, friends, any doubt, please ask me. What I have done, I have just substituted the values and I have multiplied. So what will be the next step? Yes. It is u into v, product of two function. So therefore, you have to write like this. So this is I into. First, I keep psi as it is, differentiate phi with respect to x plus phi as it is, differentiate psi with respect to x. Is it clear? Same way, continue with next. This is j, keep psi as it is, differentiate phi with respect to y plus keep phi as it is, differentiate psi with respect to y plus k, keep psi as it is, differentiate phi with respect to z plus phi, differentiate psi with respect to z. Any doubt, please ask me. Psi and phi are the function of x, y, z. Please remember this. It is a function of x, y, z. Psi is a function of x, y, z, and phi is a function of x, y, z. So we have to write product of two. Okay, now simplify. Simplify the values around C. Open the brackets. And I want here all the value of phi. If I want common five terms, where are the phi? Psi is there, sorry. This is psi is here. Here we have psi and here we have psi. Okay. So I want to remove psi, then your I into dou phi upon dou x will be there. Right. Same way here, j into dou phi upon dou y will be there. And here k into dou phi upon dou z will be there. So I can write like this. Is it correct? Just see here. I into dou phi upon dou x plus j into dou phi upon dou y plus k into dou phi upon dou z. Is it clear? Yes, students, if you have any doubt, please ask me. Very simple multiplication, and I have taken psi outside. See, if you don't understand, please ask me. I will repeat once again. Yes, is it clear, Yash?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you for a reply. Plus, I will continue. Now, I will take out phi outside. Okay, now see. Look at the screen. So, I will tell you how to identify what you have to take. And okay, so here you can see phi, where it is. This is phi we have, this is phi we have, and here we have phi. I want to take out phi outside, but please see I is multiplied to this. Here you can see j is multiplied to this and k is multiplied to this. So when I remove phi outside, you can see I into dou psi upon dou x plus j into dou psi upon dou y plus k into dou psi upon dou z. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now you simplify. Yeah, this is phi is there. In the bracket, you can see I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z into phi. I will just take out phi outside, plus phi I into dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z. This is function, okay, into this is psi. So therefore this is psi into del of phi plus phi into del of psi. Okay, which is nothing but this is equal to phi. So here dot is there. Okay, please remember this is dot is there. Gradient of phi plus phi gradient of psi. Is it our RHS students? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So therefore, this is RHS. So LHS is equal to
RHS.
RHS, that's it. Okay, will you try for the next one? Please try. Let us see how many will get the answer. So this type of examples are definitely, you will get one or two examples in the exam. So go slow, write down correctly. So here you can see what we have calculated here. Yes. So what we have to prove, gradient of psi into phi is equal to psi gradient phi plus phi gradient psi. That is what we have proved. Okay, try the next one. Second identity. So you can take del of phi plus psi is equal to डेल ऑफ फाई प्लस डेल ऑफ साई। Prove that. Okay, always these are all prove that. See, question is also given, answer is also given, students. Please see, easily you have to take LHS and prove RHS. In between you have to manage. That's it. Okay, so let us try. So I will take here LHS. Quickly you can solve now. This is del of psi plus phi. So how you will write this? Del is nothing but I into dou upon dou x plus j into dou upon dou y plus k into dou upon dou z. Please try this once. Psi plus phi. Quickly you have to solve. Okay, so how you have to solve? Already I told you, take this, multiply inside this bracket. So how you will get? Yes, look at the screen here. So this is equal to I into dou upon dou x phi psi plus phi plus j dou upon dou y psi plus phi plus k into dou upon dou z psi plus phi. Okay, so just simplify this. Open the brackets. So here it will be. This is easy than previous. So when I open the brackets, this is I dou psi upon dou x plus I dou phi upon dou x plus j dou psi upon dou y plus j dou phi upon dou y plus k dou psi upon dou z plus k dou phi upon dou z. So this is equal to, now what I will do, I bring all the psi one side and phi one side. So I will write like this. Yes, see as runs. I, all the psi's I will bring. One psi, this is one other psi, and this is one. So three psi's I will bring. So that is I into dou psi upon dou x plus j dou psi upon dou y plus k dou psi upon dou z. This one I have brought one side. Okay, plus next what is remaining? It is I dou phi upon dou x plus j dou phi upon dou y plus k dou phi upon dou z. Okay students, easily you can write like this now. So here what I get? Yes, next step, you have to tell me now, this is equal to, I will remove from this bracket psi, I will remove outside. So this is I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k. Oh, I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z dot psi plus I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z into phi. So this is equal to del psi plus डेल फाइव इज इट अवर RHS? यस पूजा,
सर,
वी गॉट द RHS?
यस सर,
यस, वेरी गुड. इज इट इजी?
यस सर, यस सर.
यस, वेरी गुड, एक्सलेंट. सो डेफिनेटली दिस टाइप ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स आर फिक्स इन द फाइनल एग्जाम, सो यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस. सो दिस इज आवर RHS. सो LHS इज इक्वल टू RHS. What is LHS here? Del of phi plus psi. Okay, that is proved. Will you try the next one? Next one, I will little bit make it difficult. Okay, let us see. Do you get the answer? Write down third one. Take down third one, friends. Third one. So prove that. What do you have to prove? Prove that divergent of pi into f is equal to pi into divergent psi into divergent f plus, yes it is, del psi into f if, what is that? If f is equal to f1i plus f2j plus f3k. So this is a little bit tricky. So again, in the exam, please students remember that if they don't give you f, okay, consider f. Suppose in the exam they give only this to prove. That time what you have to do? You have to remember this. Remember, f is equal to f1i plus f2j plus f3k. You have to remember this directly, okay? If they don't do give in the exam, then you have to remember. Okay, sometimes they don't give. So you have to get confused and you will lose the marks. Is it clear? So these are the tricks you have to follow. Okay, quickly we'll solve this now. Again, LHS is equal to RHS. That's it, students. So one by one we will take LHS is equal to RHS. So I'll just take here LHS is equal to divergent of psi into f. Okay, we'll solve one by one. So this is equal to divergent is written as del. So this is del dot psi into f. So please solve this quickly. You can easily solve this runs. Substitute always del. What is del? Just now I told you. Please remember, del is equal to I into dou upon dou x plus j into dou upon dou y plus k into dou upon dou z. Just substitute the values quickly. So this is equal to I into dou upon dou x plus j into dou upon dou y plus k into dou upon dou z. This is pi into psi into f. Okay, then simplify one by one. You will get the answer. Yes, students, please multiply this. So I take this inside the bracket. This I dou upon dou x phi into f plus j dou upon dou y psi into f plus k dou upon dou z psi into f. Okay. Simplify, you know the differentiation now, right? So just simplify this. This doubt is out. Okay. Yes, so this is equal to I into, so I'll simplify this like this. I'll keep phi as it is, differentiate with respect to x plus. Now I differentiate with respect to phi and f as it is. Okay. So continue. Plus j phi dou f upon dou y plus dou psi upon dou y into f plus k phi dou f upon dou z plus dou phi upon dou z into f. So now simplify this, friends. Okay. Take psi outside. Wherever psi is there. So this is psi is there. Here we have psi and here we have. So I is multiplied. Here j is multiplied. And here k is multiplied. Therefore, what you will get? Psi into I into dou f upon dou x plus j into dou f upon dou y plus k into dou f upon dou z, right? Plus, yes. Here you can see remaining things, I will bring it on this side. So you can see this is I dou phi upon dou psi upon dou x plus j dou psi upon dou y plus k dou psi upon dou z dot f. Okay. So continue this runs. So this is equal to, this is phi. Directly you can see this. You can take now I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z. I'll take out phi u f, sorry, plus. Same here I will take I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z. Here it is phi into psi into f, psi dot f. So this is equal to psi. This is going to become divergent of f plus, and this is going to become del of phi dot f. So a little modification is required. Okay. So therefore, this is RHS. So LHS is equal to RHS. That is divergent of psi into F is equal to psi into divergent of F plus del psi dot F. This is a little bit trick, but definitely this type of examples will be asked in the exam. So we'll solve the last problem. So we'll finish. Yes, students, please write down. Yes, Pooja, have you written? Aishwarya, have you written?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. What happened to this? F. Dou F. Dou upon dou S. Plus G do Y. Okay. So will you try the next one? Fourth one? Fourth identity. Prove that. Prove that. This type of example will definitely come. Divergent of curl of F is equal to 0. So I think you remember divergent is dot product and curl is, can anybody tell me what is curl? Yes, Aishwarya, Pooja.
So curl, don't know, sir. matrix form.
Ah, correct, excellent, very good. See, remember divergence. You write it down, is dot product and curl is cross product. Okay, where you get the determinant, right? Do you remember that divergent is determinant you get? Dot product, simple, corresponding elements are multiplied, like I and I is multiplied, J, J. KK is multiplied. But when you take cross product, remember that it's a determinant or matrix. Yes, very good. At least that you remember. Okay, we'll solve. Just solve this problem quickly. So we'll take this solution. So here I will take LHS. LHS is equal to divergent of curl of F. So please remember, whenever divergent comes, runs del dot you will get. Okay. And whenever curl will come, it is del cross F. Fix this in your mind. Whenever divergent comes, del dot product will come, and whenever curl will come, it is a cross product. Some homework I will give you, try practice. So these are all known as vector identity, students. Please remember, this will come in vector calculus. So this is the last part of the vector calculus. This is the last part of the class. And one simple homework I will give and we'll finish it. So this topics will get over. Okay. This topic will get over. Today, you just practice this example, students, again and again. Okay. Solve this. So one by one you see. Substitute the values properly. That is very, very important. I tell you. First you substitute del. Del what we have? I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z dot. It is again del cross f. Okay. Del cross f. So what I have to do? I have to take this inside the bracket. This you can do easily. This is a dot product. Easily you can take it inside. So I will write like this. I into dou upon dou x del cross f plus j into dou upon dou y del cross f plus k into dou upon dou z del cross f. Is it very difficult?
No, sir.
Yes, students, write down. Very simple steps they are. Only thing you have to practice. Multiplication you have to practice, right? Product you have to practice. Cross product you have to practice. Matrix you have to practice. Determinant you have to practice. Very simple topic this is. Vector calculus is very, very simple. Hardly a few steps are there. Only multiplication is there. And partial differentiation you already done. And hardly one or two formulas are there. Okay, quickly you simplify now. Yes, what will be the next step? I have to again substitute del value. So I will write like this. I dou upon dou x. I will put first a del value. I will put it in bracket again. I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z cross f. This you have to continue for J and K, same, nothing more, not difficult. Only I am substituting what is the formula for del. So I dou upon dou y remains as it is. So what is remaining again? I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z cross f. Plus k dou upon dou z outside inside the bracket I dou upon dou x plus j dou upon dou y plus k dou upon dou z cross f. See, whenever you come across cross f run, you should be very careful, huh? Cross is nothing but the curl f. Okay. Yes, friends, have you written it down?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you should be fast, okay? So this is equal to, now I will simplify. So before simplifying this, I will use one formula. This is a simple formula. I think you have come across already in the distribution. I think in 10th you have studied this. A dot b cross c is equal to A cross B dot C. So this simple formula I will use. What is that? A dot B cross C is equal to A cross B dot C. So where this is applicable, just see here. See, look at the screenshots. Very, very important step one. This is, if you don't understand the next step, it is very difficult to simplify. So be careful. Here. So one by one, just simplify. And just take up. So which equation you have to simplify, you should know. Okay. This much is enough. Okay. So one by one I will simplify. This is equal to, it's gone up again. Okay. This equation I want. Okay, so here I will take first one equal to. Now A dot B cross C means I will take this part as A. I will consider this part as A dot. This is my B part cross F or C. Is it clear? Is the well, you can look at the screenshots. Actually, I would have taken this down. Okay. Yes, is it clear? I will take this part as A, this part as A, and this part as B, and this part as C. Is it clear? So this step is a little bit tricky. You have to understand. Is it clear, friends? See here, this part I will take A, this part I will take B, and this part I will take C. A, B, C. Okay. So now what I have to write? A cross B dot C I have to write. So how you will write this? Or you can just split this bracket because you may get confused here. So because every time this is A, B, C, let me solve this. Then we'll apply this. Otherwise you will get confused. Let me open this brackets again. Okay, so what I will simplify? I into dou upon dou x. So here I get I into dou upon dou x cross F. Is it clear? So plus, what I am doing is I'm just multiplying this brackets, okay? I'm just multiplying this two. Then plus I into dou upon dou x. Just open the brackets. Nothing I'm doing, okay? Dou upon dou x in the bracket. I into dou upon dou x cross F plus next I into dou upon dou x in the bracket. Sorry, this is J K into dou upon dou z cross F. Any doubt, please ask me. Just I'm opening all the brackets. Yes, friends, any doubt, please ask me. Similarly, go for the next bracket. Continue. Here, what we have? J dou upon dou y, I will multiply inside this bracket. And cross F, I will multiply. So, what I will get here? I will get plus J dou upon dou y is there, right? In the bracket, I get here I dou upon dou x cross F plus J dou upon dou y in the bracket J dou upon dou y cross F plus K. I'm just opening the brackets, okay? K into dou upon, right? This is J. J is outside always. J into dou upon dou y. Inside bracket, this is K into dou upon dou z cross F. So continue this for K also, okay? So plus K dou upon dou z. In the bracket, you will get I dou upon dou x cross F. Plus K into dou upon dou z and J dou upon dou F cross F plus K dou upon dou z K dou upon dou z cross F. Just runs all this 9 values you will get. Is it clear? Just open the brackets. Yes, friends. This is little bit tricky, and definitely you will get this in the exam. I am telling you seriously. Definitely this is in the exam. So you have to practice. Practice this problem again and again. 2 times you practice, 3 times you practice. Now, after opening all the brackets from the previous step, what we have done here, we have taken here already. Just I have opened the brackets and I have multiplied. Now I will use that formula so that this will be easier. So here I take this as A dot bracket C cross B cross C is equal to A cross B dot C. This formula I will use. Now see one by one. First one equal to this is this I will consider A. Yes, students, please look at the screen. This part I will consider A dot B cross C. Okay. Now, how I have to write A cross B dot C? Is it clear? I have to write A cross B dot C. If it is vector product, again, what is vector? I, J, K are vector. So therefore, I will write like this. This is I cross I. Is it clear? Because I is a vector and dou upon dou y, dou upon dou x into dou upon dou x will become dou square upon dou x square f as it is, no change in f plus. So write for all, follow the same step for everyone, all the values. So I will write like this. In the second step, I will take this is A, this is B cross C. So therefore, this is going to become I cross J dou square F upon dou x dou y. Okay, so this is going to be dou x डो वाई प्लस आई क्रॉस के डो स्क्वायर एफ अपॉन डो एक्स डो जेड. सो बाय यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला इजिली यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस. सो प्लस हियर कैन सी जे डो अपॉन डो आई विल कंसिडर दिस एज ए. दिस पार्ट आई विल कंसिडर बी क्रॉस सी. सो हाउ विल राइट ए क्रॉस बी डॉट सी. सो दिस इज डॉट आई विल गेट दिस एज डॉट हियर आई विल गेट द डॉट डॉट. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बिकम जे क्रॉस आई डो स्क्वेयर एफ अपॉन डो वाई डो एक्स प्लस जे क्रॉस जे डो स्क्वेयर एफ अपॉन डो वाई स्क्वेयर प्लस आई क्रॉस के डो स्क्वेयर एफ अपॉन डो वाई डो जेड. नेक्स्ट प्लस नाउ आई विल कंसिडर दिस पार्ट एज ए डॉट बी क्रॉस सी. सेम वे फॉर ऑल द थ्री. सो हियर कैन सी स्टूडेंट दिस इज के क्रॉस आई डो स्क्वेयर एफ अपॉन डो जेड डो एक्स प्लस के क्रॉस जे डॉट डो स्क्वेयर एफ अपॉन डो जेड डो वाई प्लस के क्रॉस के डो स्क्वेयर एफ अपॉन डो जेड स्क्वेयर. यस स्टूडेंट्स लिटिल बिट ट्रिक इज देयर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द ए बी एंड सी एंड वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट. दिस इज अ वेक्टर प्रोडक्ट ओनली. आई जे के आर वेक्टर्स. It is simple. Please write down properly. I am going very, very slow. Okay. Tell me what is the answer of this. If you simplify, use the note of. In the beginning, I have given the note. What is the total value? Yes. Here I will tell you the trick. If you don't know how to simplify, please. At least you can do this. I request everyone, at least you write down the directly RHS. What is RHS, Yash?
It's a curl F, it's a zero.
Zero, very good. That's the answer. That's the zero. Yes, very good. Excellent. At least you have to write this. You will get full marks. RHS is zero. Very good. That is the answer. Is it clear? Yes, Aishwarya, Pooja. You write directly zero. The examiner or the paper evaluator will definitely give you out of out marks for this example. Now I will tell you why it is zero. Yes. Now you see, I have given in the beginning. Yes, can you tell me I cross I is equal to what?
So zero.
Zero. J cross J is zero means this is zero, this is zero, and K cross K is zero. Is it clear? Okay, this is zero. Okay, fine. This is zero. Now, I have given another problem. That is, whenever you take J cross I. Yes, please tell me what is J cross I?
So K.
Yes, it is minus K.
And minus K.
I cross J is K.
K.
Yes, so means where it will be zero, I will show you. Sweet. Just last step. Okay, so here you can see in this I cross J is there. And in this example, you can see J cross I is there. So is it not becoming K and here minus K?
यस सर,
माइनस के एंड के, यस, सो देयरफॉर दिस इज ऑल्सो जीरो. इज इट क्लियर? सेम वे इफ यू गो ऑन सिंप्लीफाइंग लाइक दिस, आई एंड के, सो दिस इज रिवर्स ऑफ दिस वन, आई एंड के. यू कैन सी दिस विल बी जीरो, इट विल गेट कैंसल. वॉट इज रिमेनिंग? विल मेक इट इन स्क्वेयर बॉक्स. दिस इज रिमेनिंग एंड दिस इज रिमेनिंग, सो इट इज एग्जैक्टली रिवर्स. आई क्रॉस के एंड के क्रॉस जे इज अपोजिट ऑफ ईच अदर, देयर फोर दिस इज गोइंग टू बिकम जीरो. सो अल्टीमेटली एवरीथिंग इज जीरो, देयर फोर द आंसर इज जीरो. यस स्टूडेंट्स, सो इट इज वेरी इजी, जस्ट यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस एंड सिंप्लीफाई. इफ यू हैव स्टिल डाउट प्लीज आस्क मी.